Hello everybody, this is Masood Ansari, Department of Psychology, KPSN College, Baroda. Today we will discuss about the social psychology, its significance and definition, and also we will try to defend its term, that scientific study. How is it scientific study? We will also discuss and try to defend it. So before going through the definition, I would like to share some social context so that we can understand the social psychology better. What kind of content it covers? Suppose a few years later from now, you may receive a letter in the mail inviting you to a high school or college reunion. You will probably feel a bit nostalgic and you will begin to think about those old school days. What thoughts will come to you first to your mind? Will you remember the poetry you finally began to appreciate in your junior years? Will you think about the excitement you felt when you completed your first chemistry lab? Will a tear form in your eye as you remember how inspiring your social psychology class was? Maybe other incidents also you can recall. But what will probably dominate your thoughts are the people you knew in school and the interactions you had with them. The long and intense discussion about everything imaginable, the love you have, you lost or wanted to desperately to experience, the time you made a fool of yourself, the day you sat in the pouring rain with your friends. Why we are thinking about these social context, social situations? We can also think about the problem solving and rational thinking as well. But why we are focusing these situations? Yes, we are focusing on these social situations because we are human beings. We form our individual identities not alone, but in the presence of other people. We work, we play, and we live together. We hurt and also get hurted, and as well as we help each other. We define happiness and success for each other, and we don't fall passively into social interactions while we actively seek them. We visit family, make friends, we give parties, and we also build up network. So one of the exciting aspects of learning about social psychology is discovering how basic and profoundly important these social relationships are and how these relationships affect to the human being. There are two studies I would like to share which have been done by different scholars. First one is emphasizing on the positive impact of the social relationship, which is conducted by Agrawal in 2008. He found that having close friends and staying in contact with family members is associated with health benefits, such as protecting against heart disease, infection, diabetes, and cancer. And these all factors lead us to live long and be active. It means that having good relationship, good network of people around us, it may positively associated with the better well-being and you can say mental and health, physical health as well. Another study conducted by Bush in 2006 that is emphasizing the negative impact of the social relationship. He found that those children who are socially excluded from the activities by their peers or neglected by family members are more likely than other children to suffer academically as well as socially in school several years later. It means that it is not necessary that whenever you are neglecting or rejecting anybody or excluding a child, its result will come out today or just next day. But the impact of that negligence will come surely, and it might be horrible, and it may affect significantly and negatively to the development of that particular child, or you can say individual. Suppose during his development and learning process, if this kind of incident take place, it will affect their growth and learning as well, and its outcome will be not appreciable. So precisely because we need and care so much about social interactions and relationships, the social context in which we find ourselves can influence us profoundly. You can find many examples of this kind of influence in your own life. Many incidents take place during our daily activities. Have you ever laughed at a joke you didn't get just because those around you were laughing? Do you present yourself in one way in which with one group of people and in quite different way with another group? The power of situation can also much more subtle and yet more powerful than in these examples, as well as in other unspoken expectations about you, literally seem to cause you to become a different person. Expectation towards us from the other counterpart may also influence our behavior, our personality, and our activities. Suppose one of your best friends is expecting that you are not smoking while you are, then what will you do? Probability is that you will try to avoid the situation where your friend is there and you are smoking. You will try your 100% and you will put your 100% effort to escape from these situations. But you know, consciously or unconsciously, if the situation is persistent, there is probability that it will make permanent change in your behavior, relatively permanent change in your behavior, only because of the presence of your best friend who is expecting that you are not smoking. It means that social situation is influencing your behavior, your activities, your day-to-day life routine. Now come to the social psychology definition. What does it mean? Actually, social psychology is the scientific study of how individuals think, feel, and behave in a social context. Or we can also say, social psychology studies nature and causes of human behavior and thoughts in social context. In this definition, there are three points to be noted. First one is scientific study, and second one is how individual think, feel, and behave, and third point is social context. Now come to the first point. Whenever we talk about the scientific study, what will be the first question? Probably first question may be, there will be pure science or very precise study, and that will be definitely scientific and valid, more reliable. While we are talking about social psychology is a scientific study, how can we defend? And before defending that social psychology is a scientific study, one should know what are the assumptions to be any subject scientific. So we will first discuss about the what are the assumptions, or you can say what are the criteria for being a scientific study. So there are 5 points. Whichever subject will follow, that subject can be categorized under the scientific study. First one is define the problem. Second is define your variables and measurement techniques. Third one is data collection. Fourth is analyze data and draw conclusion. And fifth and last point is result. What does it mean by these 5 points? Suppose there is a problem regarding internet addiction among adolescents. We can understand nowadays teenagers are very used to use the social media as well as internet surfing. So it is gradually being addicted. They are gradually being addicted of the internet and social media. So first point, as I have mentioned, define the problem. So our problem will be the role of internet addiction on the well-being of adolescents, we can say. For example, so this will be our problem. Then after, we have to go through the background of the problem. Is there really they are internet addicted? Is there really the factors who is contributing towards the internet addiction? Then after, second point we will come to define different aspects and dimensions of internet addiction and well-being as well. And at the same stage, we have to decide how we will measure the internet addiction. There are many psychological tools for the different variables through which one can measure the psychological phenomena. So there is also internet addiction scale. One of them is also developed by me and my colleague. So after the decision and finalizing the scale of the internet addiction, we will go through the data collection. There may be different kind of statement regarding internet uses and social media as well. So suppose we have collected 500 response from the different areas of the respondents, and we come back and starting to scrutinize and screening, and then after analyzing the data. Definitely, while we are using the same scale for the all 500 participants, so definitely there is a probability that there must be some common answers. Then we will filter and come to the some conclusion that how much of those 500 participants are mildly internet addicted, moderately internet addicted, and highly internet addicted. After the analysis and getting conclusion, we can say that yes, there are 30% of the participants are mildly internet addicted, while 60% of the participants are moderately internet addicted, and rest of them are highly internet addicted. So there is a predefined sequence of the processes that we have to follow. I mean, there is a stages of, there is a five stages through which one have to go and accomplish their study. If any subject, any discipline following these steps, we can say that this is a scientific study and that discipline is following scientific method. Now come to the social psychology. So we can say and we can defend that yes, social psychology is a scientific study. Why? Because social psychology and other branches of the psychology as well, for any study, for any research, they follow the same processes. That's why we can say that social psychology is a scientific study. Now another question is there, why social psychology uses the scientific study? Why not common sense? So very simple answer is there. Social psychology uses scientific study because it's reliable, valid, and we can also generalize. Because these steps are well defined, scientific, and we can trust of them. So one of the example from the common sense I would like to share. Suppose common saying and common sense says that out of the sight, out of the mind. It means someone of your near and dear, if went far away, we or you will forget him. Is it possible? It may or may not be. There are two conditions. Suppose I have only friend, not any other. So what will happen? And he is also very close to me. In that case, if he will went far away and didn't have any connection, any contact for a long time, even after, I will not forget him, because we have a very good bond between us. But in case of another situation, suppose two friends are there and their relationship is not too much strong, and there are many friends instead of that particular person, then what will happen? There is probability that he may forget that first one friend, because he has another options too. So there is a two answers for the one question or one assumption, that out of the sight, out of the mind. That is why social psychology do not use the common sense. It's use scientific study, scientific method. So another point of the definition is how individuals think, feel, and behave. If you will notice, there are well established fact that there is a individual difference. We all agree. Even twin of the same parent will have somewhat differences among their personalities. So these words point to another important way in which social psychology differs from some other social sciences. Suppose sociology. What it does? Sociology typically classifies people in terms of their nationality, race, socioeconomic status, and other group factors. While in case of social psychology typically focuses on the psychology of the individual. Even when social psychologists study groups of people, they usually emphasize the behavior of the individual in the group context. Suppose in a hotel there is a room number 400D and there are the number of people, but among them one individual is too much hungry and he is searching for food, while rest of the individuals are walking very normally. Suddenly the person who is too much hungry saw a number which is written as 400D and he thought that there is written food, while rest of the people are not thinking so. Why is it so? Because individual differences and contextual differences. First person is hungry, that is why his concentration is only on the food, while rest of the person are doing their daily routine as usual, no problem at all, they are not thinking about the food. That is why social psychology focuses on the individual, not on the group. Even when it studies the group researches. Now, third point is social context. What does it mean? Which has been mentioned in the definition. Whatever the social psychology studies, it studies under the social context. The socialness of social psychology varies. In attempting to establish general principles of human behavior, social psychologists sometimes examine non-social factors that affect people's thoughts, emotions, motives and actions. For example, they may study if hot weather causes people to behave more aggressively. Now, what is the relation between aggression and hot temperature? While it is somewhat has influence on the individual's behavior, that is why social psychologists try to understand what extent of the temperature has significant influence on an individual's behavior and how they react. We can notice and we can understand very well during hot summer vacation or any other month of the summer like May and June. So another context of the social psychology to be study the social context is social psychologists sometimes study people's thought or feelings about non-social things, such as people's attitude toward Nike's versus New Balance basketball shoes. How can attitude toward basketball shoes be of the interest to social psychologists? One way is if these attitudes are influenced by something social, such as whether LeBron James' endorsement of Nike makes people like Nike. Both examples determine whether heat causes an increase in aggression or whether LeBron James causes an increase in sales of Nike shoes are social psychological pursuit because of thoughts, feelings or behaviors either concern other people or influenced by other people. Daily and usually we see that many well-known personalities like Amitabh Bachchan, Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan are promoting different products of the companies. Suppose Amitabh Bachchan is promoting Cadbury Dairy Milk Chocolate, and he appreciates that it tastes very good and I like it. Then what will happen? People who is following, people who are following Amitabh Bachchan definitely will admit that yeah, Cadbury milk, dairy milk is very good chocolate. And now we can observe this fact. Every children, if they are, they have somewhat understanding of the chocolates, if you will ask which chocolate do you like, definitely or most probably they will say dairy milk. Why is it so? Because they are used to see on the television that very good personality and well-known personality like Amitabh Bachchan is promoting Cadbury Dairy Milk Chocolate. Another example we can take, like Salman Khan. He is introducing a product of medicine, that is Revital. Whenever he comes to the screen and say, "Bhag daud ki zindagi mein thakna mana hai, Revital." While nowadays it's banned in the market because of some technical issues. I mean to say that personalities like Amitabh Bachchan, Shah Rukh Khan, Sachin Tendulkar, Salman Khan, who are introducing or promoting any product, there is a high probability that followers of them will accept those products. So this is the social influence of those personality on the layman. So the social context referred to in the definition of social psychology does not have to be real or present. Even the implied or imagined presence of others can have important effects on individual. For example, if people imagine receiving positive or negative reactions from others, their self-esteem can be affected significantly. And number of examples can be there for the social impact on the individual. Suppose at the time of lecture on the podium, some individuals are getting fear and shivering. What kind of factors are working there? Is there anybody going to ask him why you are speaking from there, why you are doing so, why you are emphasizing particular point, why not another? No one is going to ask him. But even though he is getting affected, why? Because whenever he is delivering lecture or speech, he can observe the expressions of individuals. Some may smile and some may getting angry and some may getting bored of the lecture. So these are the impact of social context on the individual, and because of these context, social psychology try to understand that what kind of factors are contributing towards the human behavior, their reactions, feelings, emotions, motivations, and so on. So now concluding remarks is that we are saying that social psychology is a scientific study. So now we can say that yes, social psychology is a scientific study. Why? Because It follows scientific method, and there are 5 points, 5 stages, which followed by every researcher in the psychology. And why it's focusing on the individual? Because every individual has their own characteristics, personalities, qualities, advantages and disadvantages. So one kind of research or finding cannot be implemented to all of the same age group or different age groups. It definitely it will have some limitation. So, and all these researches, studies take place under the social context. So social psychology emphasizes the individual's behavior in the social context. So this is all about the definition of social psychology and significance of its area of study. So if you have any question, you can contact in our interactive session, which will take place as and you will get information about that. So thank you for your patience.